the most significant jolt in the housing industry in 100 years. And I believe that to be true. The headline article in the New York Times today and the LA Times, Realtors slashing commissions. The National Association of Realtors announcing today a $418 million settlement in the damages from the seller commission lawsuits. Now, if you haven't been following this, this video is not for realtors, although it might be helpful for the realtors that watch my content. This is for the consumers who are thinking about buying or selling a home in the next 12 months and what a disruptive force this is going to be in the market. Let me tell you what it means for you as a seller. You're going to be in a position to pay 1, 2, or 3% commission to sell your home like no time before. Like this, you're still going to need the best marketing, the best effort, because yeah, you can put a house up in the right area and a real estate agent can sell it in a day with 13 offers if it's priced right and all of that. But there's a lot that goes into that. So this isn't going to change the fact that home sellers need to hire the best real estate agent who does the Facebook marketing like we do, who does circle marketing and prospecting, who pushes the house out to everybody in their database, who takes and fields a 3 or 4 dozen phone calls to get the right prospects viewing the home, takes professional photos, virtual tours, all that stuff. And that's expensive to do. So there's still going to be a cost for that as a home seller. What's changing is really going to be more disruptive to the home buyer and the buyer's agent process, because this lawsuit effectively states that the National Association of Realtors has decided on behalf of all of its roughly 1 million members, of which I'm not a member, but I am a real estate agent and a mortgage loan officer. I'm just not a member of this organization called the National Association of Realtors. This is one of the reasons, because they're not looking out for the best interest of either the consumer here or the real estate agents, in my opinion, that are part of their organization. They're looking out for their power and affiliation in the marketplace. And so today, they've taken the dues that have been hard-earned by roughly 1 million or more real estate agents paid into their organization, and they've given them to home sellers in various states and to lawsuit attorneys that have brought suit for, I think, a legitimate reason. They said that it was an antitrust violation. It was illegal that the Board of Realtors and real estate companies and the multiple listing services colluded together in a way to price fix commissions so that sellers were forced to pay typically, not always, but typically 5 or 6% to sell their home. Now, it's going to be a situation where those MLS offers to cooperate, by and large, are going to go away. We've already seen this before today's bombshell announcement of this $418 million settlement. Quote from the NAR, "They have worked hard for years to resolve this litigation in a manner that benefits our members and American consumers. It has always been our goal to preserve consumer choice and protect our members to the greatest extent possible." This settlement achieves both of those goals. This settlement doesn't achieve any of those goals. This settlement does not fix the fact that we are in an industry that's broken. I'm talking about the housing vertical at large. I'm not talking about finance. I'm talking about real estate marketing, real estate agents, the world of Zillow, Trulia, all of that stuff, how social media interacts with this industry. The average consumer has been delivered no choices. And so what's going to happen is this is going to kind of set the world as we know it in real estate on fire. What do I think is going to happen? How am I going to deal with this? Well, how I'm going to deal with it is what I'd already planned to do to begin with. You know, after 25 years of being in this business, I've come back to the ground floor of it, because I saw this as a time where my knowledge and experience could be quite helpful to my database of clients and customers and friends to offer the solution before the solution presents itself. So if you want to list a home and your home is either expired from another agent, it didn't sell because it didn't work out, or you are thinking about putting your home up in the next 6 months, my view is simple. You pay me a fee that we negotiate that's between 1% and 3% commission. That means if it's a $1 million home, $10,000 to $30,000. If it's a $400,000 home, $4,000 to $12,000. We negotiate that based on what you need from me. And then we offer to the selling agent, the person that brings the buyer, nothing. Zero. Because I'm going to be the selling agent. Ultimately, for the longest time here, and I think this is what really brought this real estate lawsuit forth, is that the average listing agent who does a really good job is really bringing the buyer. Because when we put it in the MLS, we put it out to the realtor community at that point. Yes, but most of the time what's really happening is it's going to Zillow and Trulia, and it's the skill at which we take the photography, stage the house, present the house, answer and field calls, follow up with prospects, and then social media this day and age, you can literally target people who've already been shopping for homes just like yours by paying big bucks to social media companies and Google and being in Microsoft to put your home as a home seller in front of all these people. So ultimately, if someone shows up and they want to buy the house I have listed, it's easier on my client, the seller, and on me to work with that buyer, let them be a customer unrepresented. If they need representation, they can pay someone to do that, hire an attorney to do contract work for them, just like you hire an attorney to do contract negotiation if you're buying a business, right? And you could hire a real estate agent for that if you want to pay them directly, or you could just do your own self-representation. I don't exactly recommend that. But if you wanted to do that, my marketing as the listing agent is what brought the buyer to the property to begin with. And that's what the seller's already hiring me to do. So to have the buyer's agent get paid for simply having the keys to open the door, I've always thought that was a broken process. I really think what's about to happen in the marketplace is that we're going to see a major cataclysmic shift in how real estate is conducted. In other words, the real estate agents who work with buyers and represent them in the process are going to have even more of a meaningful role. But it's going to be a much more elite circumstance. You've got all these big teams who produce all of these contacts and buyers, and their big sales pitch has always been, work with me, I represent you for free. Well, you get what you pay for. So the seller is paying the buyer's agent out of their commission, out of their equity, rather. And then the buyer's agent doesn't really have to develop skills. They just have to keep it between the lines. But now you've got to go to a buyer and say, listen, the seller's not paying me a commission. They're saving a lot of money now. That's not going to change the value of homes in the market, I don't think. And then the buyers are going to say, well, wait a minute, I don't want to pay 3%. I've never had to do that. So I'm buying a $500,000 home. I can't pay an extra $15,000. So the buyer's agent has to really provide a value for that to work. And that's going to be a huge shift in the market. Now, as with all of my videos, we're going to do a bigger update on this at the first of the week. This video is coming out on the 15th of March. So on the 18th or 19th, we'll put another video on the housedog.com, Bryan Crabtree channel on YouTube, and across the platforms and on the website at housedog.com, updating you as sellers and homeowners about how to use this news to your benefit. That's ultimately my goal as a consumer advocate. My hope is that you'll do business with me so that I can help guide you through the complicated process. If you have a home to sell, I'd love to walk you through how this works from a marketing perspective and come up with a commission rate that's somewhere between 1 and 6%, 1 to 3 paid to me. It's your choice. It should always be the homeowner's choice about how they go about selling their home. It's your equity. And my job is to protect your equity and earn a reasonable fee for doing that. And so if you need a consultation, you'd like a home equity checkup, you'd like more details on this, how it may impact you, your house has come off the market with another real estate agent, you're thinking about listing with a new real estate agent in the future, or just simply putting your house on the market for the first time, let me give you a home equity checkup. There's no cost or obligation to that. And then from that point, I can help you be armed with the details and information to make the best decision about moving forward in real estate in 2024 with what is and will be the biggest shakeup in housing in 100 years.